Yep. This is kind of fun sliding down the hill.
Hey guys, Garage 79R. As you can see, I'm sitting in my garage, and I'm not sitting on Floyd. I'm sitting on Earl. Got Earl running a couple weeks ago. About 3 weeks ago, I guess it is now. Put in a 98 spec motor I got from Dustin. Underbrace. That's about it. I didn't do anything special. Cleaned up. Wiped down the engine bay a little bit. It's not perfect. Painted the valve cover. Tried to do black crinkle. And I tried to use a torch to help it dry. But I think... Well, not think. I agree with my buddy Austin. Because I was wondering why it didn't crinkle as good. You can see it's a light crinkle. And it's not bad looking. It's a little dusty now, but... He thinks because I used the torch, whatever, like, vapors or something that activate the crinkle, I burned them off. Probably so, but it still looks better than filth. So, you might wonder why Earl's in the garage, where's Floyd? Floyd's in my shop. About 2 weeks ago, I got a little greedy with the boost and went up to the mountains, and I end up throwing rod number 4. So... Thin rod DIS at 18 pounds of boost. Well, I knew it was going to happen. Like, I'm not mad. I'll even put the video I took when I scattered it and we're walking down the mountain looking for the engine, block. Pieces of the block on the road and whatnot.
Jesus Christ. There's not... Whoa! I'm sliding.
There you go. Here's the block.
Yep. This is kind of fun sliding down the hill. Yep, right here.
Why is there so much more oil?
Well, the car pukes
well,
oil.
It's running down the hill, too.
Yeah. Oh, shit. Okay, I'm going to hurt myself.
Here you go. Here's
yep, that's cast iron.
So I'm not even mad. It was going to happen.
Maybe somebody come around the corner up there and plow into our shit and drive off. It looks like it starts right here.
Yeah, it was here, because I started to climb in the boost. And the fact that I even made it that far up the hill.
I'm not mad. It's just the timing is just, oh man, it sucked when it happened. And I was so far away, so the tow bill was a lot. But I was on borrowed time. And I don't think directly the boost was the culprit. I think it was a combination when, about 15 minutes before the rod let go. I was at full throttle, right at the top of second, it was about to shift, and I kind of went over a bump and the car unloaded. It was raining, so the car unloaded enough where I spun the tire and thwacked the limiter real hard, and it couldn't figure out the shift in time, and I heard this like, as it was smacking the limiter, and I was like, I think that's what did it in. And then, so 15 minutes later, I was full boost, going heading up back up the mountain, and just let go. I mean, that rod did some damage to that motor. So I'll put the pictures in. It's got a hole on either side of the block, and it cracked both ears for the bell housing. I took one of the bolts out because I was going to try to use it on something, and the bolt was actually bent. I mean, that is some force. I mean, full load, 18 pounds, that rod had some energy to work with. So I'm not mad at just the timing. But I decided to... take the opportunity to go ahead and put the 1NZ in. I decided I don't want necessarily 1NZ this car because there's always a small chance I might need to sell this car. So I need to sell it more as a standard car. I can't sell it as a modified car. Like if I go to sell this, I'll put my 5-speed in. I used to have my white kart. I used to race. It's a 5-speed with a Corolla or MR2 gear set. I can't remember now. And a TRD LSD. But that will get removed if I go to sell this car. Because technically I sold this transmission to my buddy John, and then I borrowed it back for the time being. So, me and my friends were always going back and forth with parts. It's actually borderline ridiculous how many times parts go back and forth between us. But such is car life, such is car guys. So, this is running fantastic, other than it wants to idle a little high, and I'm not sure why. I think it's probably because it's not EGR. The 96, 95 and 96 had EGR. 97 and up did not. So I got like the thing hooked up, like this little solenoid, but obviously there's no ports, there's no nothing, but it's still throwing the EGR code, and I'm wondering if that's maybe why it's idling high, because I got everything adjusted down. It's only a little bit. It's like idling like 1100. It's not bad, so I'm not really that concerned with it at the moment. But yeah, it looks good, runs really good. It was 0-60 in about 10 seconds. I'll put that video in now. It's just a fun little car. The suspension's soft because it's probably the original struts. So it tilts and rolls and no sway bar. I might put the stock one from Floyd on it eventually. But it's just a fun little car to drive. It's a stock Tercel. I forgot how much fun can be. The 5-speed really helps. You know, automatic really saps a lot of power on these cars. But, yeah. Earl's alive. Oh, and the exhaust freaking whistles. Only thing I could think of is I had to redo the front pipe to clear the underbrace, and all I had was 2-inch piping. Stock is 1 3/4. And so where it goes into the cat, I kind of had to the pipe had to be like rolled in, and just a little bit so I can, you know, seat it in the front of the cat, and then I could lay a nice weld. And the only thing I could think of is maybe that slight taper combined with the rapid expansion of the cat is creating a whistle, or there's like walnuts in the muffler or something. I don't know. But it's hilarious because it straight up whistles. Not like a turbo. It whistles like a whistle almost. And so you might be able to hear it in that video going to 0 to 60. But it's definitely louder on the outside. And it makes me giggle almost every time because it's just so stupid and funny. But it runs good. The gas mileage seems to be good. I've been driving all over the place, and the needle barely moves, which is nice compared to Floyd. Because Floyd was getting about 27 miles per gallon there with, well, all the boost and going through that automatic. So, I'll put some pictures in of the progress of Floyd. So, motor's in. I got that in yesterday. It's not completed. It's not running. It won't be running for a while. Because I still got to locate a manual harness and a manual ECU. Automatics are easy to come by in the Echo, XA, and XB, but the manuals are getting hard. I didn't pull the harness and stuff from the donor car because that was already hacked up, because a lot of times on the 1NZs, people like using the coils, and they snap the harness to get the pigtails for the coils. So I'm a little groggy right now. So it's hard to find a harness that's not been cut. And then also on top, it's hard to find one in a manual because the manuals just aren't as common. So I'm hoping to find a harness and ECU, and I'm going to try to combine a harness with the Tercel harness and, you know, try to make it work. I could send it out and have it done, but I'm going to try to do it myself because I don't learn if I don't try. And it'll give me a little bit of a precursor before I get into the Malibu. That's what's going on. You know, so the motor's in. I had to modify the back bracket. So, driver's side, transmission bracket, straight up. I mean, it still had the mount from the XA on it. Bolts right in. The rear one, I had to use the Tercel trans bracket for the backside of the motor and, or transmission, I had to use the Tercel bracket, but I had to cut the ear off the Scion bracket and weld that onto the bracket for the Tercel. The Tercel bracket, the little tab could have lined up. There's another hole, but you would require like a spacer, and the hole is not tapped and it's not deep, so it wouldn't have been that strong. So it was easier to cut the old tab off the Tercel bracket and weld on the Scion tab in the upper hole position like it was originally intended. And it wasn't hard. It wasn't rocking science. Just cut it off, weld it, and reinforce it. Done. It's pretty much anybody can do it. You know, if you got any kind of basic fabrication skills, you use the transmission as the jig, and you do it. And so you'll see. I'll put the pictures in. Motor side, that was a little bit of a pain, but not far-fetched. So on that, I had to drill out all the spot welds for that, remove that engine mount ears, I guess, bracket, whatever. I went and got an Echo XA and XB. I'll use the same engine side mount. It just so happens the only decent one I can find was out of an Echo. I pulled one before that, and it was mangled and pieces were missing. I don't even know how it was in service, because the car wasn't front end. It didn't have front end damage, but this engine mount was fucked. So I pulled one out of a nice silver Echo. It was in good shape. It's not perfect. I'll get a new one, but it was fully intact and it was easily to be, you know, ready to be used. I had to trim some meat off of it, but otherwise I was able to use it straight up. When I leveled the motor out, it worked out where there was just enough gap underneath the engine mount where I can put a plate underneath of it. And the plate I drilled and tapped and then welded to the frame. And so that worked out perfect. So basically I drilled two holes in the frame rail so the bolt can pass through. And I used this 3/16 plate, drilled and tapped it, and then welded that in place. I still got it kind of like fully, it's only partially welded right now. And I still got it fully welded. I'm going to put some more reinforcement on it. And I got pick up on the second or third tab coming off the mount that kind of like stabilizes it. I got to build a thing to that. But the motor is in. It is supporting its own weight in the car, or the car supporting its weight. And it's in. And so that was the hard part. Well, maybe not. The wiring is going to be the hard part. And later on this week, I want to test fit the axles. They should just straight up, you know, be reusable. There is a little bit of room for a header or a turbo. It's still doable. Just gotta be, you know, mindful. I mean, the axle's gotta account for the axle. But it's nothing I can't handle. It's the car. The motor's gonna be put in with basically some sort of shorty header I'll build, and some sort of intake, because obviously I can't really use any of the stock stuff. But it'll be put in pretty much, other than that, it'll be put in stock. And I just want to get the car back on the road and enjoy it. So maybe we'll see it in a couple months. It just depending on when I can find a good donor car for the harness and the ECU. And when I can find the time to get the wiring done. So that's what's going on. So Earl is up and running just in time to replace Floyd for the time being. Go figure. I was trying to get a car out of the shop, but it is what it is. And I'm still rocking the 13s because those tires still have plenty of tread. So, I got Stop Tech brake pads in there I got from Austin. It actually stops pretty darn decent for standard Tercel brakes and on 13-inch wheels. But yeah, that's what's going on. I'm trying to find time to work on the Malibu, and I've been trying to set everything up where I can work on it for the month of July. Well, just, you know, scattering the motor and Floyd, I don't know yet. July may not happen for the Malibu, but I'm trying. I was going to try to do it for April. That didn't happen. So I'm trying to have July dedicated to the Malibu. Or at least, all I really want to do is get the fabrication work done. And then I could bring it back here, and then eventually I can get to the wiring harness and the fuel system and whatnot. So hopefully soon we'll have some Malibu content, because I'm tired of that car just sitting, and I can't enjoy it if it's just sitting. So So I want to get that car running, and it'll be a lot of fun. So that's what's going on. Busy guy. I picked up another day of work at the tooling shop, and just gotta find time to get stuff done. Y'all have a good one. See you later.